there is no doubt that our solid mahogany replica of the Resolute Desk is a fine piece of furniture that anybody would be proud to own. But what makes it so special is the story of why it was given by Queen Victoria to the President of the United States and came to be used by nearly every president ever since. The story starts when relations were improving between the United Kingdom and the United States after a little bit of unpleasantness called the War of Independence. And Congress was looking for a really special gift to show goodwill and to break the ice, so to speak. Funny enough, the answer came from the Arctic, and the story is told on the brass plaque.
HMS Resolute, forming part of the expedition sent in search of Sir John Franklin in 1852, was abandoned at latitude 74 degrees 41 minutes north, longitude 101 degrees 22 minutes west in May
18... The HMS Resolute was one of five ships that had been sent in 1852 to try to rescue the ill-fated Franklin expedition. The Resolute got completely stuck in the ice and had to be abandoned by her captain and crew, who transferred to one of the other ships. Over the next year and a half, the ice pack slowly drifted south and began to melt. The Resolute was found drifting 1,500 miles away without a soul on board by a Boston whaling ship, which towed it back to port. Congress earmarked $40,000, which is about $1 million in today's money, to purchase it and make it as good as new, and then it was sailed back to England in 1856 as a sort of peace offering. The British media went crazy over this magnificent gift, and Queen Victoria received it with great ceremony. Much was made of the restoration of the sails and rigging done in the Brooklyn shipyards, perfect even down to making new flags to replace the originals that had gone mouldy. The Resolute again saw useful service in the Royal Navy for the next 20 years. Finally, the time came to break it up and recycle the English oak from the ship. The desk was made together with a twin. Although it was not an identical twin, it was a writing table. Queen Victoria, who was still around, decided to present the desk to President Rutherford Hayes and to keep the writing table for herself in Buckingham Palace. She had brass plaques made that record the story of the HMS Resolute and then state,
"And is presented by the Queen of Great Britain and Ireland to the President of the United States as a memorial to the courtesy and loving kindness which inspired the offer of the gift of the Resolute."
Loving kindness might be a bit over the top, but you can see that diplomatic relations had improved no end. Over the next several years, the desk was used by US presidents in various rooms in the White House.
"Be cut off within 1 week. These people are living from
changes which are cited to justify it.
Guidelines laid down by my predecessors.
Possibility of turning our nation's economy around.
Your job or your savings as a consequence."
President Franklin Roosevelt wanted a desk to use in the broadcast room, and a matching panel was made with a presidential seal in order to hide his leg braces because he had polio. The panel was weighed with a locking door, as it was originally intended to keep a small safe for valuable documents behind it. Unfortunately, President Roosevelt died before the panel was completed. Under President Truman, the White House was completely remodeled and the present Oval Office was built. After the Second World War, President Truman also changed the eagle on the presidential seal so that it looks towards the olive branches of peace rather than the arrows of war. When President Kennedy was elected, Jacqueline Kennedy took the decoration and furnishing of the White House in hand, and it was she who had the Resolute Desk cleaned and refinished and moved to its present site in the Oval Office. The famous pictures of the Kennedy children playing under the desk while the father was working were taken here. After President Kennedy was assassinated, the desk was put on display in the Smithsonian, and it remained on display until President Carter asked for it to return to the Oval Office. When it was brought back, the top was turned so the brass plaque faced the chair, and so it has remained ever since. President Reagan had a favorite chair and found the desk was too low, so he had a plinth made to raise it by 2 inches. Our replica also has the separate plinth. We are constantly striving to make our replica as true to the original as we can. The main difference is we have chosen to make our desk from mahogany rather than English oak, which is extremely tough and difficult to carve. The English oak trees used to be the property of the Crown, since they were used to make sailing ships for the Royal Navy. We use Honduras mahogany, which is grown on old Dutch plantations on the island of Java. This is a sustainable source of this beautiful wood, which has been used for centuries to make fine furniture. I'm David Newton of Victorian Replicas, and thank you for sharing this history of the Resolute Desk with me.